This is a tutorial one. Today we'll discuss about geometry, two dimension, parabola, ellipse, and hyperbola. So I have already discussed arity geometry, two dimensional straight lines, circles. Now I complete by discussing parabola, ellipse, and hyperbola. So let's start. First, we introduce what is eccentricity. What is eccentricity? Eccentricity is very important to define parabola, hyperbola, and ellipse. So, first, we introduce eccentricity. How eccentricity actually expressed by small e, and what is the meaning of eccentricity? How it is defined? First, take two axes, x-axis and y-axis in the Cartesian plane. Now, if x and y, if we have a locus of any point in such a way that any variable point such that from a fixed straight line it is a directrice, this is called directrice. This fixed straight line is called directrice. From a fixed straight line and from a fixed point, the point must be fixed from anywhere. You can take on x-axis or any other point. So I am taking on x-axis to better interpretation of this geometric representation. So I am taking on x-axis. You can take anywhere, but this point must be fixed. Now, if the distance from any point, a variable point, from the directrice and from the fixed point actually the ratio is called the eccentricity. If the point you take S, which coordinate is xy, this is variable point, and P is the SP is the distance from the straight line AB, which is a directrice AB to the point S, and the fixed point you take AB, there will be the ordinate is equal to 0, abscissa is A from the origin, so A0 I am taking. So the ratio SP by the HM, M is the quadrant point, fixed point, is called eccentricity. Now, depending on the value of the eccentricity, we will get many different type of geometrical representation. This is called eccentricity. So, eccentricity is eccentricity defined the ratio between the any variable point to the fixed straight line, the distance, and from the fixed point and the from the variable point and some fixed point. So this ratio is called the eccentricity. Now take find E can be three types. E may be less than equal less than 1, E can be equal to 1, or E can be greater than 1. So for three categories, three type of different values of E, we get three kind of geometric representation. For this E less than 1, we will get ellipse. We will get ellipse geometry. And for E equal to 1, will get parabola. There will get parabola. And for last, you can very easily guess this must be hyperbola. And for this last, if we get greater than 1, we will get hyperbola. So now we will discuss how the three can be formulated and their equation. Their equation we will derive. All of three properties and equation of ellipse, parabola, hyperbola we will derive. First we will start parabola. Now what is when we will get parabola? When eccentricity is equal to 1, means sp is the distance from the variable point to the directrice. So sp by sm is the variable point to the fixed point. The ratio is equal to e is equal to 1 here for parabola. So you will get that sp and sm always be equal. Sp is equal to sm. If any such point, variable point, we will find that from a fixed point and from a fixed straight line, if the distance always be same, then we get the structure of a parabola. Eccentricity must be 1. So what is the structure of parabola and how its equation can be read? This is the matter we will discuss now. Now parabola, I am taking very ordinary level of parabola, means it is its fixed point, which is we will call later the focus, is on the x-axis. It is a very ordinary level of parabola, and then I will derive the general case of parabola. Just to make understand easily, I am taking the directrice perpendicular on the x-axis. This is the directrice. It is perpendicular to the x-axis, and the fixed point taking I am here. So the point, if sp is equal to sm always, then we will find that we will get such kind of structure. Here the fixed point is called focus, which I have taken A0. I am taking again A0. Its FCCI is A and ordinary is 0. So here if S is any point, and since we want to derive the equation of the parabola, we are taking the general or variable point xy. So sp is the distance from the S point to the directrice sp, and sm, this point is m, this point, and sp and pa, sm, sp by hm, both are equal. SP and SM are equal because we are taking the eccentricity must be satisfied equal to 1. So how to calculate its its equation, parabola's equation? Now if you can look this here, S can be any point on the parabola. Now since SM and SP is equal to 0, so when SM S come to the origin, then SM will be A, and SP will be what? SP will be OQ. Just imagine S when comes at the point origin, then SM and OQ, OM and OQ equal to, both are equal. We are taking SP is equal to SM. So if this is a, so this must be minus a 0. So the equation of the directrix you can very easily calculate. This must be x equal to minus a. This is the equation of the directrix. It is evaluated through the focus point. If we know the the value of the focus, where the fixed point is lies, then we can very easily calculate the equation of the directrix. Now, we want to evaluate the equation of the parabola. So, we know SP is equal to SM. So, we are taking the distance between S to M. We want to evaluate the distance SM first. So, through this relation, we will calculate the equation of the parabola. SP will be what? From the point XY to X equal to minus A. So, we know the distance will be SP will be SP will be if we write it x plus by plus c in form, it will be x plus a equal to 0. Then the equation from any point xy to this directrix, the distance will be x plus a and being below square root of 1, so x plus a. And what will be the SM? SM will be distance between two points. Meaning this will be x minus a whole square plus root over under root over plus y square, y minus 0 y square. Now both are equal. What we'll get? We'll get x plus a equal to root over x minus a whole square plus y square. Now if we we want to the root over, then this will be x plus a whole square is equal to x minus a whole square plus y square. Now, if we know, we already know about the algebraic formula of this, this will be x square plus 2ax plus a square. The same side will be x square minus 2ax plus a square plus y square. Since x square and left hand side and right hand both have the same sign, this will be subtracted. We will get 0. A square will be subtracted and we will get 0. Then at last we will get y square equal to 4ax. This is when the parabolas the parabola focus is on the x axis. This equation will get when the parabola's e is the focus or fixed point. So focus here we will call when parabola's focus point is on the x-axis, then you will get this relation, and the parabola must pass through the origin, then we will get the equation. But in general cases, it cannot be happen. Parabola can be in any side, can its focus point can be on x-axis, y-axis, or another part. If we will take a general case, take such kind of case, that here the parabolas directrix take in this way. This is the directrix, and parabolas, this is the perpendicular on the directrix, and this passed through the focus point, focused of the parabola. So this is how we are taking. Not we will take a zero now. We will have to take alpha beta. We are taking alpha beta. It is a coordinate point. This is I have denoted by m, and the directrix I am taking AB as earlier. AB. Now any general point on the parabola xy, we take. We are taking xy here. Xy. Now this is the distance from the point from the directrix. This is SP and this is SF. This in the structure these are looking not equal to, but actually SP and SF must be equal for generating a parabola. So SP and SM is equal, always is equal to always equal to. So now here are the focus is not A0, now is alpha beta. So how we will calculate it? Now take that this is the ordinate is beta. Here this is beta and this is y. We'll shift. Take the transformation theorem to evaluate this value. So now this is alpha. This distance is alpha. This is S, and this is just x. This is just x. Now, so what will be the this? This will be, this must be beta alpha minus x. This will be alpha minus x, and this distance, this is, I have said y, and this is beta. So this must be, this distance must be y minus beta. Y minus beta. So from this we can very easily calculate the SM through these values, and to know the SP we need to know the equation of the directrix, which we do not know. So we will take the equation of the equation of the directrix is general straight line equation ax plus by plus c or minus c is equal to 0. Or plus c equal to 0. I am taking ax plus by general equation. So now both can be calculated very easily. Sp will be SP will be AX one point is to notice that here the distance of the focus is means patient. Patient is the when this point comes to this point, then we see the origin at this point. We don't know the where this point lies. We are taking this is I am taking just CD. And then the distance can be calculated through this distance between this point CD to alpha beta. Now from this we will get the focus distance of the focus. So here when x equal to c and y equal to t, then we are generating this will match clear ax plus by plus c by root over a square plus b square. As we know through the analytic geometry, this distance and distance between the value of SM will be very easily you can calculate SM because it is a right angle. So SM will be root over I'm taking square SM whole square, it will be alpha minus x whole square. Y minus beta square. When we if we take SP square here also, then here we will get whole square form, and here we will get root over cancel of the root over. So we will not get the root over. So root over will not be abolished. Now SP and SM is equal since by the condition of eccentricity that SP and SM must be equal. So we will get SP square SM square must be equal. So we will get this relation. From this we will get very easily the equation of the parabola. But what will be the at that moment, what will be the focus length? This need to be calculated. So I'm calculating now. So we will get in that side alpha minus x whole square plus y minus beta whole square is equal to x plus by C whiskers minus 1 A square plus B square.
अंकल के जिंदा हो बाबा।